Hey dudes and chicks, and neither of those rules don't apply to you. Welcome to Rick Foster. My name is Katie. Today, I am going to be popping this palette's cherry. This is the New Zealand Stargazing palette by Nomad Cosmetics. You guys all know, we were all like shitting our pants when we saw the color story. It's fantastic. It's totally on theme with what has been on my heart lately. So obviously, Nomad has been rocking these multi-chromes lately. Mine came smashed, and quite frankly, the mirror came smashed at the exact same second as another product that I'd ordered that was in a glass bottle came smashed. And so I'm really disappointed that all my glass was broken when I fucking pulled everything out of the mailbox. And quite frankly, no shade, but I do feel like it had to do with packaging. This came in an envelope mailer with padding around it, and so did my glass bottle of foundation that I wanted to try. And so they both came in a kind of a, rather than a box, they came in a more eco-friendly packaging, which I support. I'm all about it. But when all my glass shows up at my doorstep broken and they're all in like more eco-friendly packaging, like, what am I supposed to even say right now? I'm an asshole because I'm irritated that my mirror came this smashed. There was glass all in it. So honestly, I wouldn't recommend anybody else using it with that much glass in it, as was in it. But what was I gonna do? Everything I ordered that I was expecting to film with yesterday came smashed. So that's annoying, but that's no fault of the brand or the palette. And I was super excited to get this filmed. So this is what the color story looks like, and I'm gonna get some swatches for you guys. Okay, this is Dark Sky Nation, and it's the black in the top right hand corner. This is Carter Observatory, which this is probably, I mean, aside from the shimmers, this is like my favorite color in here. Ooh, that's really nice. This is Carina Nebula. Ooh, this is really pretty. Ooh, these shimmers are really slick. And the embossment is gone, period. This is like a pinky goldy shift. I don't know if you guys can see the gold, but it's really shifty. This is Oakland Stardorm, or Auckland. It's the rose colored pink, and I just fucking love it. Ooh, look at that. Don't even need a second dip on that, do we? This is Araki Mackenzie. I'm not sure what it is, but it's like a neutral to warm tone purple. Actually, that's a pretty even Steven purple. It swatches really nicely. It's really bold. I don't care for this color in particular. I mean, compared to this color, but needless to say, I mean, it's indubitably pigmented and blendable. I used it on this look, so. This is, oh my god, Tekapo Stargazing, or Tekapo. Leave it to Nomad to make sure that we couldn't pronounce a single fucking shadow. No, just kidding. But seriously, am I? Okay, this is Milky Way. Oh, never mind. I can pronounce that one just fine. This is like the blue to purple fuchsia shift. Just, like I said, so slick. This is the Cosmos. It's the gray in the very center. Nice. Man, these mattes are just nice. This is Jewel Box. Not sure what that means, but there's a Saturn on it. Oh my god. That is fierce gold to pink shift. Wow, this is really pretty. Ooh, that's really fucking pretty. Dang. Love. This is Southern Lights. I really like this color too. Obvi. This is Southern Cross. This is a really nice pink to green to gold, but the green is like a teal blue. Oh, wow. Purple. You can't even see the green. Okay, I think you can see the green on that, on the downside. This is Tongariro Night Hike. I actually like this color, I think. It's nice. Yeah, I like that a lot. This stole my heart and the show, as far as I'm concerned. It's like a, it doesn't really show that much in the swatch, but it's like a gray-blue to pink shift, and it's just shocking. It's on my inner corner, and it's just so beautiful. This is Queenston Skyline. Queenston, right, my UK people? Not Queenstown. Maybe it is Queenstown. It probably is. It's not the same place. And then this is Magellanic Clouds. Or I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing that right, but this is like a gold to peach, and it's just magical as well. Matches that peach above it just intensely. There's an intense relationship between those two. These are the swatches. I'm just going to tell you right now, all of the shimmers are fantastic, but these two right here have my heart big time. And this cool toned, all these cool tones and these pinks, like the blue is what I wanted to use immediately. Like I wanted to use the blue, but I'm not sure why. I just was drawn to it. But you guys know the colors I love in here are like the cool tones. So anyways, let's get into the look. Okay, so I'm going to start with the color Tecapo Stargazing. Tecapo. This blue. It actually looks a lot more like rich and dusty in real life than I think it looks on camera. But I'm just going to use my Voldemort VM506. And, I mean, hopefully. And I'm going to start putting that in the inner or the outer V. And, oh yeah, oh yeah, that's really nice. This reminds me a lot of the blue that was in the Winter Bitch palette by Notoriously Morbid. Can somebody please let me name the palettes from now on? I was just wondering. This color story in this palette is so workable. I mean, it's like has so many great options that I honestly had a hard time deciding. And the option I chose, I feel like is maybe a little unique. I haven't really watched anybody else's reviews except Nikki Raven's eye swatch. So hers is the only video that I've watched on this palette. I feel like I was going to get this palette no matter what, but when I saw Nikki Raven's eye swatch video for this palette, it like tipped the scales. Like it put me right over the edge. There was no going back from that video for me. Okay, now I'm going to go into Iraqi Mackenzie. This purple. This warm tone purple with another Voldemort VM506. And I'm going to use that to blend this out. I'm just going to go 50% on and 50% off. Not a lot of kick up in this shade. A little more in the other one. I'm just like getting a line laid down right here. This isn't my favorite shade of purple, so I'm just using this as a transition into my favorite shade of pink. So I feel like if I would have blent that pink with this blue, I would have gotten a purple that I maybe would have liked to do business with a little more. This is a really primary purple, like a pretty, I would say it's warm tone for me, but maybe it's just my vision is a little obscured because I use so many cool tone purples. I think it's probably a pretty neutral purple or like a very even blend of red and blue. And then with the, I guess I'm going to use the Wayne Goss number 18. And I'm going to go into Oakland Stardome, Oakland. Just not sure about that. And I'm going to go 50% on and 50% off. This actually looks like a galaxy. I wish this pink would have been a little lighter. I should have went a little lighter on the dip, but I feel like this blend right here is exactly the colors that they have on the cover. Like, I feel like I accidentally just fucking nailed that. What am I gonna do for the inner corner? I'm gonna go with Carter Observatory, which is, you guys know, the real color that I wanted to use is Carter Observatory. I guess maybe I'll use this Spectrum B04. It's like an angled brush, and I'm gonna go into Carter Observatory and put that in the inner corner. Ooh, I love that color. I do not love this brush. For this, anyway. Ooh, that looks really good. I wish I would have done that good of a job on the other side. Why didn't I? What's the difference? Good Lord. So I'm just pulling this into that like warm tone purple just because I love it so. And I'm just gonna use this big fat Spectrum B06 to kind of blend out that outer. And then I'm just gonna go back in and kind of start to reinforce all the colors. This is the blue. I just thought of my ex. That's what that face was. Sorry, my face gets away from me. I literally had no idea I was doing that until like, well, you saw me catch myself. It's funny. This is the purple. Now this blend is starting to fucking really come together. And now I'm gonna go into the pink. I just went for the slightest dippy poo. All right, I'm gonna do the bottom, the lower lash line with just the same brushes. Damn, that looks really pretty. I mean, it honestly looks a little bit crazy right now, but the blend looks really nice. The reason why it looks a little crazy is because I have a lot of pigment all the way to the brow bone. So like, I don't care for that at all, but I kind of knew that was gonna happen if I used that. If I used the pink instead of these lighter shades, I knew that this was gonna be, this is a mid-tone, so I took it all the way to the brow, so my fault. I didn't put any extra color on here because this pink is super pigmented. You're not gonna hear any complaints about a pigmented pink from me. I just dipped into it. And I'm gonna dip into it again, and I'm really just pulling it heavy in the front. Okay, I'm gonna use my AOAE 131. And put on my NYX glitter primer. This might need a black. Oh shoot, I don't know what colors I'm gonna use. Well, I know what one color I'm gonna use is. My Unearthly UC84, this brush I love for picking up shimmer. And I'm gonna go into Milky Way, Obvi. There's the There's like a nice green in this. There's like a green shift. Okay, and I guess I'm gonna use Southern Cross across the top. I'm gonna go into Southern Cross with my finger. Damn, that looks fucking good. It's crazy. That looks so pretty. Okay, and then I think I'm gonna go into Aurora Australis. Australis. I'm not sure what that word is, but I'm gonna use my Unearthly pencil brush, the Unearthly UC86, and I'm gonna go into Aurora Australis. I feel like this, oh no, I'm wrong. It's gonna be very bright. Ooh, this is the fucking, oh yeah, that's the fucking star of this. Holy fuck, that's the gift that keeps on giving. Like, as I was pulling it this way, it was like turning into a different color. Damn! Oh my god, stop it. Okay, and I'm just gonna kinda, I use my finger to do that blending because I kinda wanted to hurry it up a little, but I'm just gonna kinda take this and just start tapping. How's that look? Perfect. Well, it's throwing my camera out of focus. Okay, and I'm gonna take a little, I'm gonna take this Voldemorphe M562, and I'm gonna go into Dark Sky Nation and kind of just deepen up that outer V to give me some more dimension, because I took away the dimension when I went all the way to the brow bone with a fucking mid-tone. So I'm just gonna keep this in the outer V, like in it, and then also like take it to the line where the top of my shimmer is. So I'm just gonna go right here. I love that. And it was easy. Boom. Okay, this is the final look. I'm gonna go finish the rest of my face and fix my hair, and I'll be back when I'm done. So this is the manifesto, the piece de resistance. I used my Rouge and Rogue eye wigs in Miss Fury, my Unearthly blush in Punch, my Rituel de Fee highlighter in The Fawn, my Sugar Pill lippy in Hijinks, and my Urban Decay 24/7 glide-on eye pencil in Woodstock on the waterline. I think this looks really good. I did go back in at the end and put some more of that pink on and kind of blend it into my blush, blend it down, get it more pigmented. And then I also went in and put that color Aurora Australis on the brow bone, and it gave it kind of a more of a spacey look. So anyways, I think this looks really pretty. I do feel like I kind of went a little crazy up to the brow, but I put on that shimmer shadow and it really changed the game. The shadows blend beautifully. Everything works amazingly. I feel like this for me has been giving me the most joy out of the entire palette. So that was kind of a surprise. I thought it was gonna be a little bit dull, but it's actually really got a really unusual like gray blue shift. And honestly, I feel like that's the one that I saw, now that I'm thinking about it, I think that's the one that I saw on Nikki Raven's Swatches that was like, that was the color I felt like I couldn't live without, and I almost didn't even use it. That's hilarious. That's hilarious how ADD works. Okay, so anyways, I love this palette. I think the color story is amazing. I honestly kind of went a direction where I kind of went a different direction than what I actually would have preferred, but I feel like this really gives it the spacey galaxy look that I feel like the look that I created is the look, like, that represents the palette, the theme, everything about it. So it was an accident. I didn't fucking mean to do that. I just did. So anyways, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell because you can't wait to see what happens next. Hit the like button if you like this look or if you just like my sparkling personality and my boyish charm. And hang out with me in the comments because I fucking love it. If you got like halfway through this video and you're like, oh my god, she's so pretty until she opens her big fucking mouth, then go check me out on Instagram. I don't talk as much on Instagram. And if you were like, don't sugarcoat it, Katie, why don't you tell us how you really feel, then go check out my Patreon, which is actually going to be changed to a membership here by the end of this month. So check that out. It'll be more accessible to you guys. You guys all get more notification of what's going on there. So thank you guys so much for watching. You could have been anywhere, but you're here wasting your time with me, and I totally appreciate you. Later.